बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वेलकम टू द कोर्स ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स वेरिएबल्स एंड ट्रांसफॉर्म्स एंड दिस इज़ आवर लेक्चर नंबर 15। टुडेज लेक्चर इज बेस्ड अपॉन द मेथड ऑफ सेपरेशन ऑफ वेरिएबल्स। द मेथड ऑफ सेपरेशन ऑफ वेरिएबल्स कंबाइंड विद द पोजीशन ऑफ सुपरपोजिशन कंबाइंड विद प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सुपरपोजिशन टू सॉल्व द इनिशियल बाउंड्री वैल्यू प्रॉब्लम। Here are the two conditions for this question to be solved. First is partial differential equation must be linear and homogeneous, and this method is called the Fourier method or the method of eigenfunction expression. Here again we will have the same question that was repeated in the previous lecture, which we have solved by the Fourier transform. Now we are solving the heat equation by the principle of method of separation. Heat equation of one dimension ut is equals to k u xx. Here is a rod of length l whose length is changing from x equals to 0 to x equals to l, and we are continuously supplying heat to this rod. These two are the boundary condition. U of 0 t at this point for the time t it is 0, and u of lt at this time u is 0, and this is the initial condition u x of 0 is equals to f of x, as we are continuously supplying the heat, which is 0 less than x less than l. Now the given equation is ut is equals to k u xx. Here x is 0, x is l, total length is l of the rod. These two are basically the initial boundary conditions, and this is the initial condition. Now we will solve this by the separation of variable method. The separation of the variable method says us, if there is a function u, if there is a function u of x . So its superposition says that the capital U of x is equals to x of x and t of t not equal to 0. This is the method of separation of variable. Now our given equation was in the form ut is equals to k u x x, which means that the first derivative of respect to time is equals to k u x x. So when you will apply this upon our given equation, left side will becomes as it was first derivative of t, so it will becomes x t dash, and upon the right k as it is, and we have applied the principle of superposition. So here we have the second derivative of u, so here we have the x capital with two derivatives, x dash dash and t as it is. Now we will separate the variables. X dash of x would be equals to t dash over kt, and these two are ultimately equals to minus lambda. Here lambda is the basically separation constant. So again I will told you what we are doing. Basically this is our given equation, ut is equals to kxx, but we are doing, we are applying principle of superposition, which says that u is equals to x of x t of t. So you will apply this upon both the sides. So this side will becomes x as it is t dash, and this side will becomes k x double derivative t as it is. So you will have this relation. From this relation, we have separated the variables x dash of x is equal over x is equals to minus lambda and t dash over kt is equals to minus lambda, where lambda is known as the separation constant. Now from this you can write the equations x dash plus lambda x is equals to 0 and t dash plus lambda kt is equals to 0. Now we separate the boundary conditions. The two boundary conditions were u at the 0 value of x of t is equals to 0 and u l of t is also 0. So as we know that u of x is equals to x of x and t of t, so u of 0 of t from the boundary condition will tell us that x of 0 t of t is equals to 0. As we know that at time equals to t, this value cannot be 0 because the time will keep on changing. So x of 0 is equals to 0. And similarly, when you apply the second condition, u of l of t, which is equals to x of l into t of t, we must equate it, it's into 0 as well. So time cannot be 0, so again x of l is 0. So from the boundary conditions we have basically interpreted the values that x of 0 is 0 and x of l is also 0. Now we will put them into our equation. Our first equation was x double derivative plus lambda x is equals to 0, where you have the new boundary condition x 0 is equals to 0 and x l is equals to l. Now we will look forward for the value of lambda. Lambda may have the three possible values and it will give us the non-trivial solution. Keep that in mind. Lambda may be greater than 0 as shown here. Lambda may be less than 0 as shown in this. And lambda could be 0. So there are these three possibilities or the three conditions of lambda that will be solved separately. For lambda greater than 0, we have different conditions for the equations. For lambda less than 0, again we have the different conditions for this. And for lambda equals to 0, we have different conditions. So there are basically three types of condition based upon lambda, and we will study each of them in this numerical. Case number one, when lambda value is greater than 0, the general solution in this case will be in this form. When the value of lambda is assumed greater than 0, then x of x would be have the solution in the form c1 cos under root lambda x plus c2 sin under root lambda x. Here c1 and c2, these two values, they are basically the constants, arbitrary constants. Now, from the boundary conditions x of 0, c1 plus 0 is equals to 0. For the first boundary condition, the value of the second derivative must be equal to 0. So it means that c1 is basically equals to 0. And for the second boundary condition x of l, we have c1 cos under root lambda l plus c2 sin under root lambda l. Here the value of c1 is 0, so the value of c2 is c2 sin under root lambda l equal to 0. It means that either sin under root lambda l is 0 or c2 is 0. When the value of c2 is 0, it will yield us the trivial solution. So you must have c2 not equal to 0. which means that sine under root lambda l would be 0 then. And when this value would be 0, here you can clearly find out the value of lambda. So it will be the eigenvalue lambda n is equals to n pi over l square. This is the value of lambda when lambda is greater than 0. Case number 1. Now the value of lambda has been known from the function, so the eigenvalue xn is equals to cn sine, as we have find out the value n pi over l, so it will take the form from this. This is 0. For the c2 we have the value. Now c2 is changed into a separate variable cn sine n pi l over x. N pi l comes from a and sine comes from this. So we have basically find out the value of lambda. Case number 2, when lambda is equals to 0, thus general solution will be in the form xn is equals to c1 plus c2, which is equals to 0. Now from the given equation in the x, that was x double derivative plus lambda x is equals to 0. Here the lambda value is 0 as given. So double derivative equals to 0 will take its integration, it will become c1. We will take its second integration, it will become c1 plus c2x. So again, from the boundary condition x of 0, c2 is 0 as x is 0, and here we have x. So c2 is 0, so the c1 value is 0, and x of l is equals to 0 plus c2 into l. Here 2 c2 cannot be 0, which will give us the non-trivial solution. Here the length can also not be 0, so this condition is not valid. The value of lambda cannot be taken as 0. Now the third condition, when the value is less than 0, in case the roots would be the polynomials and in the form plus minus minus under root, they would be in lie in the complex domain. It is convenient to get lambda is equals to minus s. The general solution in this case, x of x is equals to c1 e raised to power under root s x plus c2 e raised to power minus s. Here x of 0 as x is 0, c1 e naught plus c2 e naught is equals to 0, c1 plus c2 equals to 0, and x of l we have c1 e raised to power sl, c2 e raised to power minus sl, which is equals to 0. We see that the determination of the above system is different from 0. Subsequently, c1 and c2 must both be 0, and hence the general solution of x of x is identically 0. This gives the trivial solution, which is also not required. So this condition is not again valid. So the only condition that is valid and that would be used is when the value of lambda would be greater than 0. Lambda equals to 0 will not be taken, and lambda less than 0 will also not be taken. So I have told you these two conditions just to have the idea. Now our solution was only from the first case when the lambda was taken, and the equation which is in the x form has the solution cn sin n pi over l into x. When you solve the general numericals, you will only find out this, and these steps will be skipped. You will not apply these conditions. Now from the equation of time, t dash plus k lambda t is equals to 0. This time equation has the general solution, which you have to memorize that. The general solution of the time equation t n of t is equals to डी एन ई रेस टू पावर माइनस एन पाई ओवर एल स्क्वायर इनटू के टी, दिस इज द जनरल सॉल्यूशन एंड दिस इज द आइडिया बेसिकली हाउ यू कैन फाइंड आउट द जनरल सॉल्यूशन. हेयर टी डैश प्लस के लैम्डा टी इज इक्वल टू जीरो, विच मीन द डेरिवेटिव डेल टी ओवर डेल टी प्लस के डेल्टा टी इज जीरो. सो द डेरिवेटिव इज जीरो, सो वी हैव द वैल्यू एम प्लस के टी इक्वल टू जीरो. हेयर एम वन इज माइनस के एक्स, सो टी ऑफ टी इज सी वन ई एम वन टी. सो द जनरल सोल्यूशन ऑफ टी इज डी एन ई रेस टू पार माइनस एन पाई एल स्केयर इंटू के टी. दिस इज द जनरल सोल्यूशन दैट यू हैव टू मेमोराइज. नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द सोल्यूशन. आर इक्वेजन कैपिटल यू ऑफ एन ऑफ एक्स ऑफ टी इज इक्वल टू एक्स ऑफ एक्स टी ऑफ टी. द सोल्यूशन ऑफ एक्स वॉज सी एन साइन एन पाई ओवर एल इंटू एक्स इंटू डी एन ई रेस टू पार माइनस एन पाई एल स्केयर इंटू के टी. हेयर वन थिंग नोट दैट द टर्म विच इज विद द साइन एंड विद द ई रेस टू पार दीज टर्म शुड बी सेम, देन योर क्वेश्चन इज करेक्ट. Now here are two constants Cn and Dn. We'll combine them to make a new constant En. Here En is equals to e raised to power minus n pi over L square kt sin n pi over L into x. Where Cn and Dn are equals to a new constant En. By the principle of superposition, we have obtained the following series. U of x of t is equals to n 1 to infinity u of n x of t. Now from the initial condition that was given in the numerical, u of x of 0 was equals to f of x. This is a periodic function and this is equals to Fourier transform summation equals to 1 to n e of n sin n pi over l into x. This holds true if f of x can be expressed by a Fourier series, Fourier sine series. Now e of n is equals to 2 over l 0 to l f of x sin n pi over l into x d of x. So now we will put the value of e of n in our equation to find out the final results, which says that the summation n is equals to 1 to infinity, here the value of en 2 over l 0 to l f of x sin n pi over l of x into d of x, e raised to power minus n pi over l square kt sin n pi x over l. Here the term of e raised to power minus n pi over l is missing. So this is the final solution for this numerical. Again I will tell you that how you can solve this. The two boundary conditions were